softening or conditioning of hot water. What is by softening? The process of removal of harmless producing salt from water is known as softening of water. The softening of water to make it free from harmless producing salt substances, dissolved gases and suspended impurities. So what are the softening methods? What are the softening of water methods is followed? External treatment, internal treatment. External treatment, that is a zeolite process. Internal treatment, that is a demineralization process or ion exchange process. What is my ion exchange? So ion exchange process, removal of almost all the ions present in the hot water, cations and anions, both ions are removed from this hot water. The soft water produced by lime soda and the zeolite process does not contain harmless producing calcium ion and magnesium ions, but it will contain other ions like sodium, potassium, sulfate, chlorine, etc. On the other hand, demineralized water does not contain both anions and cations. Thus, soft water is not demineralized water, whereas demineralized water is soft water. The process is carried out by using ion exchange resins. What is my ion exchange resins? The ion exchange resins are long chain, cross-linked, insoluble organic polymers with a microporous structure. The functional group attached to the chain are responsible for the exchange of ion exchange properties. So the resins were used. What are the ions are used? The cationic resins, cationic or exchanger, and anionic resins or anionic exchanger are used. So what is my cationic exchanger? The resins containing acidic functional group like carboxylic acid and sulfonic acid are capable of exchanging their H plus ions with other cations of hot water like calcium and magnesium ions. Exchange resins is represented as RH2. The H plus ion is capable of exchanging their cations. Example, sulfonated coals. Anionic exchange resins or anionic exchanger, the resins containing basic functional group like NH2 and hydroxyl group are the capable of exchanging their anions with the other anions of hot water. Anionic exchange resins are represented as ROH2. Example, for quaternary cross-linked quaternary ammonium salt and urea formaldehyde resin. What are the processes involved in the ion exchange process? The hot water first passes through the cationic exchange resin, which are absorb all the cations like calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium ion present in the hot water. The cationic exchange resins are represented as RH2. So water containing for calcium chloride. So the H plus ion are exchanged with the calcium or magnesium ion. So formation of RCl. So remaining H and Cl, formation of HCl. So the same case, magnesium sulfate, the harmless producing salt, exchange with the H plus ion, formation of RMg, then formation of remaining H plus SO4, formation of sulfuric acid. In case of sodium chloride, so H plus ion replaced by sodium plus ion, formation of RNA. So remaining H plus Cl, HCl. So the cationic exchange resins, so all the cations are absorbed, calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium, etc. And the water containing for acidic in nature. So hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid are formed in the outlet of cationic exchange resins. That's the water, cationic free water is then passed through the anionic exchange column. The figure will be next to slide. So which is absorb all the anions like chlorine, sulfate, bicarbonate, etc. present in the water. What are the chemical reactions involved? The anionic resins simply represented as R-OH2. So that will be reacted the previous HCl and sulfuric acid. So RCl2, remaining H plus OH minus, formation of two water molecules. So the same way, the sulfuric acid reacted with the anionic resins, formation of RSO4 and H2O. So this is a simple representation of ion exchange process or demineralization process diagram. The hot water passed through the first cationic exchange resins. So the cationic resins absorb all the cations. So the cationic free water containing for hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid water outlet will come pass through the next anionic resins. So the anionic resins next absorb all the anions. So all the anions, cations, free water will come out from the anionic resins, which is called as a demineralized water. So the resin containing four, the cationic resins capable of exchanging their H plus ions with calcium and magnesium ions. So resin will with contact with the hot water. So the water containing for calcium magnesium ions which exchange with the H plus ion. So the H plus ion exchange with the magnesium 2 plus ion or calcium 2 plus ion. So all the ions are absorbed by the in the exchange with the H plus ion. This is a simple representation. So now the all the H plus ions are exchanged with the calcium ions. So there is no functional free group for H plus. So hydrogen ion, there is no free H plus. So all the microporous structure will be blocked. So we cannot able to remove harness producing water large quantities. So what will do there? Now the regeneration will be followed. The cationic exchange resin is exhausted. It can be regenerated by passing through the solution of diluted hydrochloric acid or diluted sulfuric acid. So RCA, this is called salt formation, RCA. So the hydrochloric acid is added to the all blocked resins. So the H plus ion replaced by H plus, so RH2. So remaining calcium and chlorine formation of calcium chloride. The same case, hydrochloric acid next reacted with the RNA, so formation of RH plus formation of sodium chloride. Similarly, the anionic exchange resins are exhausted. It can be regenerated by passing the solution of diluted sodium hydroxide, so RCl2. So added with the sodium alkaline sodium hydroxide, formation of ROH twice plus NaCl. So here all cationic resins are regenerated and anionic resins also will be regenerated for again the reuse of the cationic and anionic resins. So what are the advantages of demineralization process? Highly acidic and alkaline water can be treated by this process. The water is obtained by this process will have very low harness. And what are the disadvantages? The equipment is very costly. The capital investment is too high. More explosive chemicals are needed for this process. The water containing turbidity, iron and manganese cannot be treated because the turbidity reduces the output of manganese and iron, forms stable compound with the resins. These are the disadvantages. So thank you for watching. If you like the channel, kindly subscribe. Thank you. See you the next video.